King Edward VI College, Centre number 20570, Theatre Studies Unit 4, performance of The Strays. My name is Sam Whitehouse, my candidate number is 151406, and I play Ensemble, Sergei and Major Tibbs.
My name is Shekinah Singh, my candidate number is 151217, and I play the Ensemble, I play Siggy, and I play me.
My name is Elizabeth Louise Ellis, my candidate number is 150383, and I play Ensemble, a cat, the Queen, Pirouette the Dancer, and the Lion.
My name is Nicole Austin, my candidate number is 150053, and I'm playing Ensemble, Corpse Leader, Babu, and the Cat.
My name is Rose McCarthy, my candidate number is 150862, and I play Makamo, Petra, a cat, and Ensemble.
My name is Ryan Owen White, my candidate number is 150978, and I play Ensemble, Raffi, Hercule, and the Lion.
My name is Jodie Paul, my candidate number is 151035, and I play Ensemble and Charlie.
Never left it open. Never. Look, I've reached the voicemail. Look, Mum, it's not. SSC, PhD, ETC, one of the world's most famous scientists for the pioneering research of the cure for asthma. I can't take your call right now. Please leave a message after...
Oh, come on, Dad.
This is James Smart, Charlie's father, Doctor in Doctor Eco and Tropical Sciences at the University of London. I'm sorry I can't take your call right now. Please leave a message after the tone.
Oh, God, where are you?
And then, it started.
Charlie can breathe properly. Asthma is a horrible thing. Your throat contracts and your ribcage closes around your lungs like a fist. And you can't breathe. Who is to blame for this terrible plague? Man-made pollution? No. Cats, with their increasingly allergenic fur, they invade our streets like a hideous swarm. But that's okay, because Charlie has her inhaler. My company, the Corporacy, of which I am CEO, makes that. A multinational billion-dollar pharmaceutical company. You're welcome.
As Charlie got up, he saw a fast, furry thing running towards her. It was Petra, the cat from the ruins.
Charlie, you need to find your parents now.
Oh, did we mention Charlie Speaks Cat? No, probably should mention that.
Sadler left school years ago, and Charlie hasn't spoken to him since.
You haven't seen my parents, have you, Raffi?
That's all near about, Charlie. They left a note. They want you to come with me.
Dear Charlie, I'm awfully sorry, but your daddy and I had to go away for work with business. We ought to have told you sooner, but we just couldn't. You're to go and stay with Raffi. Be good and do as you're told. Love you lots. Mummy.
Okay, Raffi. Just give me a moment to pack my things, then, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll wait outside in the car.
Okay, cool.
Come on, Tom.
Something's wrong, Petra. This is my mum's handwriting at the moment. I don't trust this note. I mean, I stopped calling my parents Mummy and Daddy when I was, like, fine in work business. My mum would never say that.
She's warning you, Charlie. You've got to get away.
But where do I go?
Through the window. Head to the river. Help me waiting for you there.
Let that Charlie pack her things.
All right, you miserable, petulant scum. Get into your positions. We need to help this girl pack her bag. Okay, item number one, her phone.
Oh, check. Good.
Item number two, a Swiss Army knife.
Check.
Item number three, some money.
Check, check, check.
Item number four, a change of clothes.
Check!
Item number five, a torchlight.
Check!
And item number six, her inhaler.
Check!
Oh, God. Never leave the house without that again.
Good work.
And with that, Charlie escaped through the open window, down to the busy streets below. All right, y'all, let's get moving! Wanna see that box out the way? And you, with the step that what are y'all doing? Come on, over here, then!
At this point, Sir, the most obnoxious cat, whose presence may enrich the filth.
All right,
Well, that's a question that will come later, Charlie. Quick to the boat. There you'll find your parents in Paris. The Cap Resistance is with you, Charlie. Good luck, what's up?
Meanwhile, Charlie found a small ferry boat. She jumped onto this boat and rowed for her life. She became very tired when suddenly there was a... It was a huge ship, great crimson flags. Without thinking, she jumped onto this boat and held on for dear life.
The boat rocked to and fro until finally it came to a complete standstill. Quickly, Charlie saw her chance and clambered up onto the deck.
Oi, you!
Like rats, these children who stow away? But I'm not the Pied Piper. Trouble's watch your bread, scrawny rat!
Another hungry mouth to feed.
Is this a circus?
A circus? We are not a circus. We are the circus.
Tibbs Royal Floating Circus and Equestrian Philharmonic Academy and this beautiful ship is one you are trespassing on. Maybe you will throw him overboard like the last one.
That was fun. I'll
alert. No, you can't throw me overboard. I know that. This is perhaps that you sense that I have a magical mind's eye that can see not only the past, but the future. Oh, perhaps it's my beard.
I sense you are a fair child. Many are scared.
But not you. You are not like others. I sense that you are somewhat different. Or should I say, extraordinary.
I am Major Maurice, and I am the voice of authority on this boat. If I want to throw you overboard and feed you to the sharks, I will. If I want to feed you to the lions like a blessed Christian martyr, I will. So tell me, girl, what can you do for me?
I can speak French and English. No, wait, of course I can speak English. I can cook and I can tie knots and I can swim and I can dive and I can cartwheel and I can host something.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you're just the thing I've been looking for. The monkeys haven't been cleared out since we threw the last boy over. So sad shoveling monkey shit.
So somehow, Charlie managed to join the circus. It began to feel a lot like family. Well, sort of. But Charlie felt bad about that. Not about his parents, what they care. There was no way to find him out without some of the cats. But there were no cats aboard, only the big one.
Respect one thing.
I don't know.
Ah. Now that is disappointing.
I will find her, though, I swear.
That would be advisable, essential, really. You see, her parents just aren't cooperating. We may need to add a little more pressure.
Pressure? You mean you're going to harm them?
Why not?
It's nothing, it's just... when...
Just bring me the girl by whatever means necessary.
Pick up.
Sorry, this is Charlie. I can't come to the phone right now, so please leave a message.
Now you listen here. They have your parents. I gave them your parents. And I don't know what's going to happen to them. So you better come back soon. All right.
Oh, the child finished all her chores. She managed to go back and see the lion.
I need to speak to you. Look, the alley cat told me if ever I needed help, I should speak to her alone. And I need help. You haven't heard anything about my parents, Magdalene and Jake Stark, have you?
I hear nothing. I live in a cage. I eat dead meat when I'm not forced to play games of human entertainment. I used to be alive. I used to know things. Now I know nothing. I should be raging and plotting and scheming and escaping. But I am not. I try to attack that woman, but I become weak and lifeless. The air tastes strange to my tongue. It feels as if I am dying. It is like he has a spell on us.
It's just dirty water, that's why. But no more. I'll see to it that you get nothing but fresh meat and fresh water in. I won't end up and not hurt you, okay?
She felt them. She felt the lion's yearning for home.
Where is your home?
You call it Morocco, where the mountain and the desert meets the sea.
I bet you miss home. I know I'll miss home. I miss my parents.
Then, Charlie had an idea. She promised the lion she'd help them get back to Morocco. And the lion promised her that he would help her find her parents. If he could, empowered, Charlie took to her phone and dialed Raffi's number.
Raffi Sadler, don't you dare harm my parents. Don't you lay one finger on them, do you hear me? Because we're coming for you, Raffi.
Charlie,
Macamo, I was just...
What did it say, girl? Don't act it, silly, I see what you're talking. What did it say?
That's crazy. You can't talk to lions.
No, I can't.
Then you can.
No, you're mistaken. I was just trying to make friends.
Can't make friends with the lions. Show me how to make friends with the lions.
Okay.
Meow. Oh, great. Well, that'd be good. I see for your tricks. I'll watch your every move. When you get on deck, we're in Paris.
Maud.
Yeah. Charlie, your parents are in Venice.
Sorry, how did you...
I should go on a boat to Paris.
No, how did you know I was here?
Charlie, the lion girl. There's only one Charlie I know with an affinity for cats. I'd have to get out. The best time to go, after the circus. There'll be crowds to cover us. And the best way to Venice is on the Orient Express. First, the show.
Charlie. Here's something for your journey.
Wait, how did you know that, Roger?
I told you, Charlie. I see all that was and all that is to come. Now listen to your heart. And be careful of what's inside.
What? To make you feel like?
Charlie, the contents is precious.
Things are always as they seem.
They hide in plain sight.
These wonders that the world longs to see.
We bring to you tonight.
Our purpose is to entertain.
To perform acts oh so stupendous.
You'll only find us the tips.
Royal floating circus.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you prepared for the show of shows, the night of nights? For tonight, we shall see marvel and imagination behind these closed doors. Introducing the prancing pirouettes, the astounding city, the beautiful Babu, the ferocious Macabre. And introducing, ladies and gentlemen, our headline act for tonight, Charlie the Lion Girl!
You're so sure of yourself, weren't you, Charlie? But all that phone call did was let me know where you are. On the sea, surrounded by circus people. You should know you've royally pissed me off!
This way!
That way! Over the bridge! And past the Eiffel Tower!
Tickets, please! Tickets! Tickets, please! Welcome all to the Orient Express. Your exits are here, here, and here. We hope that you enjoy your ride with us. Thank you.
Then they were off. After the far east coast of Morocco. Before the balloon.
had even descended. The lion had leapt off. Suddenly, his golden head began to rise in the golden grass.
The lion didn't seem quite so old after all. The lion knew he was home.
But Charlie knew she had to say goodbye. She knew she had to turn her back on the lion. So she did, in her quest to find her parents. And I was glad to have played my part in her quest.
As Charlie left the Queen's Palazzo, she realised it was getting pretty dark and super cold outside. So she headed down into the busy street. And that's when she heard a strange sort of noise. It sounded a bit like... The noise was coming from inside her bag. From that tin that barboon gave her.
In Venice. Oh, don't get too close. I've got a fishing boat here that'll smell.
No, don't worry about it. We're here now. By the way, have you met Nino?
Nino, yeah, how are you? We escaped together.
Fine, thanks. Charlie, we must hurry. Our families are still in there and your parents must be in there too.
Okay, so is there an entrance or...
For us, there's only one.
Okay.
The rubbish chute.
Oh!
Just
to the cure.
Lies! You see, I don't think these cats are to blame for the asthma.
So everyone blames the cats and comes to you for your medicines.
Well, well, well. Aren't you a clever little girl, Charlie? Just like your parents, I see.
See, this is exploitation.
No, Charlie, this is called business.
Yeah, but whatever it is, I'm not cooperating.
Now that is disappointing. Take them away.
What? Get your hands off me! Can't keep you here to get my human rights!
Yell all you like. Nobody's coming.
Who's there?
You remember me. Don't you, Charlie?
Raffi? But I thought that...
You thought I'd work for them. I did.
I didn't know the cops would do this to us.
They threw me in here because you gave me such a runaround, but it seems like whatever I did, this is where I was going to end up. Just what they do. They use you. They offer you something you desperately need. And then, once you've done their dirty work, they take it away. Guess you understand now why people do bad things. Why I did bad things. Money. Everyone sees a hand feeding them, so they can't see the other hand crawling around behind them, planting the knife in your back.
1-1-1-2-0-1-1-1-2-0-1-1-1.
Nina?
Charlie? Is that you? Finally!
Who is that and why are they speaking in numbers?
She's talking to the computer.
She's what?
The security system, that's what's keeping us in here. The whole building's controlled by these computers, Charlie. I've met other models such as the QVC Windows 13, but never the 67. They're known to be a bit edgy.
You're talking to a computer.
I'm a chameleon.
Nino, can you hack the system?
What? Hack? No. But I could talk to it. Okay, I'm a little rusty, but I'll keep it crack. 1-1-1-1-1-0-0-0-1-1-1-0-0-0-1-1-1.
What the hell is going on?
We're getting out of here.
Still.
the bank!